Introductory Statistics, Module 6, Discrete Probability Distributions, Section 6.1, Discrete Random Variables. We will look at these six objectives in this section. Objective 1. We want to distinguish between discrete and continuous random variables. A random variable is a numerical measure of the outcome from a probability experiment, so its value is then determined by chance. And our random variables are denoted using letters such as X. A discrete random variable has either a finite or a countable number of values. The values of a discrete random variable can be plotted on a number line with space between each point, like this. A continuous random variable has infinitely many values. The values of a continuous random variable can be plotted on a line in an uninterrupted fashion, like this. So let's look at an example of distinguishing between discrete and continuous random variables. Here we want to determine whether the following random variables are discrete or continuous, and then we'll state some possible values for our random variable. For part A, the number of light bulbs that burn out in a room of 10 light bulbs in the next year. So this would be discrete. These are countable whole numbers, and the values would be 0, 1, 2, all the way up to 10. So there would be no decimal values in between. B, the number of leaves on a randomly selected oak tree. Again, this is discrete or countable. We can have 0, 1, 2, or more leaves. C, the length of time between calls to 911. This would be continuous. Typically, this time would be a value greater than 0, and it can take on an infinite number of values. Objective 2. We want to identify discrete probability distributions. A probability distribution provides the possible values of the random variable X and their corresponding probabilities. A probability distribution can be in the form of a table, a graph, or a mathematical formula. So let's look at an example. The table to the right shows the probability distribution for the random variable X, where X here represents the number of DVDs a person rented from a video store during a single visit. So this particular distribution shows that the probability that a person rents two movies on a single visit would be 0.22. So let's look at some rules for a discrete probability distribution. P of X will be our probability. The first rule says that the sum of our probabilities must equal 1. And the second rule is that our probability must be a value between 0 and 1 inclusive. In this example, we want to identify probability distributions. The first thing to check is, are our values for our probabilities all values between 0 and 1 inclusive? And they are. There's no value less than 0 and no value greater than 1. The second thing we want to look for is to see that all of the values add up to 1. So we want to sum them, and we'll see that the answer here is no. The values add up to be 0.97 and not 1. So this is not a probability distribution. In this example, we want to examine our values, and we see that it's not a probability distribution, because for our value of X is 5, we see the probability is negative. And remember, it must be a value between 0 and 1. So this one is not a probability distribution either. In this example, we see that all of our values are indeed between 0 and 1, and when we add them together, we'll see that we do get 1. So this is an example of a probability distribution. Objective 3. Construct probability histograms. A probability histogram is a histogram in which the horizontal axis corresponds to the value of the random variable, and the vertical axis represents the probability of that value of the random variable. So in this example, we want to draw a probability histogram. We have our probability distribution of the number of DVDs a person rented from a video store during a single visit. So that is the value that will go across the horizontal axis. And this will be similar to a frequency histogram, but our vertical axis represents the probability rather than the relative frequency. So for x was 0, we had our probability was 0.06. So we're a little bit more than halfway up here. For x is 1, we were up at 0.58. So almost to 0.6. For x is 2, we were at 0.22. For x is 3, we were at exactly 0.1. For x is 4, we were at 0.03. And then 0.01 for x is 5. Objective 4, we want to compute and interpret the mean of a discrete random variable. The mean of a discrete random variable is given by our formula here. We use our symbol mu with a subscript of x, and it is the sum of our x variable multiplied by the probability of x. So again, looking at our example of DVDs a person rents from a video store in a single visit, we now want to compute the mean. So the mean, remember, is the sum of x multiplied by p of x. So we take each value of x and multiply it by its corresponding value for p of x. And then we'll add all those together. And when we perform these operations, we see we get a value of 1.49 for the mean. So let's interpret this. Suppose an experiment is repeated n independent times, and the value of the random variable x is recorded. As the number of repetitions of the experiment increases, the mean value of our n trials will approach mu sub x, which is the mean of the random variable x. In other words, let x sub 1 be the value of the random variable x after the first experiment. X2 will be the value of the random variable x after the second experiment, and so on. Then x bar will be equal to the sum of x1, x2, all the way up to xn, divided by n. And the difference between x bar and mu sub x will get closer to 0 as n increases, meaning the two values will get closer and closer to being equal to one another. The following data represent the number of DVDs rented by 100 randomly selected customers in a single visit. We want to compute the mean number of DVDs rented. So we see all our data values here. And computing the mean, we add each of them up, all 100, and divide by 100. And we'll get a value of 1.49. And here we see a graph of it. As the number of trials of the experiment increases, the mean number of rentals approaches the mean of the probability distribution. Objective 5, we want to compute and interpret the mean of a discrete random variable. Because the mean of a random variable represents what we would expect to happen in the long run, it is also called, then, the expected value, or E of x, of our random variable. So in this example, we will compute the expected value of a discrete random variable. A term life insurance policy will pay a beneficiary a certain sum of money upon the death of the policyholder. These policies have premiums that must be paid annually. Suppose a life insurance company sells a $250,000 one-year term life insurance policy to a 49-year-old female for $530. According to the National Vital Statistics Report, the probability the female will survive the year is 0.99791. We want to compute the expected value of this policy to the insurance company. So let's make a table. Remember, we're looking at the value towards the insurance company. So let's look at our variable and then the probability of it. So our variable is the dollar amount, how much money the company will make. If the policyholder survives, then the insurance company will stand to make the $530 that was paid on the policy. And the chance of this happening is 0.99791, as we were told up above. Now, if the policyholder does not survive, then the insurance company will need to pay out on the policy. So they've still made the $530, but they're going to lose $250,000. So we subtract that from the $530,000. And we see that we have a net value that's negative of $249,470. And the probability that this happens would be 1 minus our 0.99791 or 0.00209. So the expected value then is the same as the mean, which, remember, was the sum of our x times p of x. So we're going to take 530 times our 0.99791 plus then our negative 249,470 times our 0.00209. And when we calculate this, we get a value of $7.50, which is the value of the policy to the insurance company. Objective 6, we want to compute the standard deviation of a discrete random variable. The standard deviation of a discrete random variable x is given by sigma x is equal to the square root of the sum of x minus the mean squared times the probability of x, which is also then equal to the square root of the sum of x squared times p of x minus the mean of x squared, where x is the value of the random variable, mu sub x is the mean of the random variable, and p of x is the probability of observing a value of the random variable. So let's look back at our example with the DVDs, and we want to compute the variance and standard deviation. Remember that the mean we found was 1.49. So first let's look at doing this by hand, and we'll need to make this table. We list the values of x, 0 through 5, and our mean next to it, which was 1.49. The next column in our table, we want to take each value of x and subtract the mean from it. And we see we get these values here. For our next column, we want to take those and square each of those values. Remember, when we square our negatives, we will get a positive value. Next, we'll list the values we had from our table for p of x. And now we'll multiply those two columns together to get our last column here. So to find the variance, remember, it is the standard deviation squared, so we take sigma x squared, which means we can just simply leave off the square root symbol. And we take the sum of our last column, and we see we get 0.8699. The standard deviation then would be the square root of our 0.8699, which is 0.9327. So let's look at finding the mean and standard deviation of a discrete random variable using technology. The first step is to enter the values of the random variable in list 1 and their probabilities in list 2. So I've listed the table here below. We'll press STAT and hit enter on edit. So list 1 will be our x values, the 0 through 5. We arrow over to list 2 and put our p of x values there. And here we have all our values in the lists. The next step, we'll press stat, arrow over to calc, and select 1 for one variable stats. With one variable stats on the home screen, we'll type list 1 followed by a comma, followed by list 2. So the way we do that is we hit the second button, and then the number 1 to put L1. The comma, remember, is above the number 7. Then we press the second button, and the number 2 to put list 2. And then we hit enter. We see that X bar up at the top is the mean we originally found, which was 1.49. And we see sigma X here is the same standard deviation we found using the formula, approximately 0.9327 when we round.